Hey guys, my name is Cole Munger, and sorry I have a little bit of a sore throat, but anyway. So I'm doing my presentation thing on mortgage financing. So I'll just be going through a few little interesting tidbits in the next slides. Mortgage. I just kind of wanted to define it for those of us who don't really understand fully what it is. Even myself, I don't really understand fully. Obviously, it's a loan given by a bank for a person to purchase either a primary residence or a residence for an investment. You'll either have a fixed mortgage rate or a floating interest rate. Basically a variable interest rate. If the borrower can't make the payments, the bank has the option to take the home as collateral. Basically, that's what foreclosure is. And the most common forms of debt, a mortgage is one of the most common forms of debt. And it's interesting, a lot of, let me just say it's the most advertised type of debt. So two different types of mortgages, kind of at a basic level from the research that I did, where you have your traditional fixed rate and then you have your adjustable rate mortgage, or ARM. The fixed rate, it's usually 15 to 30 year terms. These interest rates are usually higher than the adjustable rate mortgage terms, just because they stay fixed throughout the amount of years you have it for. And the obviously it's fixed, so the interest rate doesn't change. So the other type of mortgage is, like I mentioned, the adjustable rate mortgage. It's also known as the floating rate or the variable rate mortgage. This is just a cool graph that I thought illustrates it pretty well. Usually for the first while, or the initial rate, usually 3 months to 10 years, this is pretty fixed. And then after that, basically what it does is it follows an index to determine the rate of interest that you pay. So you can see it's up and down. And they usually advertise this for first-time home buyers, just because it does, in the beginning, you don't pay as much. It's kind of a gamble. You know, you never know what exactly you're gonna pay. Okay, so this next section talks about how your mortgage rate is determined. Kind of two things. One is the loan to value ratio. Basically, this is the collateral, or how much collateral you have for the bank. You definitely want a lower number for this, just because the higher the number, the more expensive your loan would be due to default in payment. And then the other one is the debt service coverage ratio, or the DSCR. All these things go way in depth. This is just kind of, I'm trying to do a basic coverage here. So this is basically the borrower's ability to pay the cost of the mortgage. So just your ability to pay. And then this last section here, just personal tips that I had before you jump into getting a mortgage. Number one is use a mortgage calculator. You can find these, this is just an example of one. You can find these online anywhere. And then, like, when you're using this, know what you can afford to do, or know what you can afford to pay. And this will really help. Also, another thing that I've learned is make sure you're allowed more than your monthly rate. Make sure you're allowed to pay more than your monthly rate. And get that in writing too, because some banks will say, yeah, you can pay more, but when it comes down to it, they won't let you. And the significance of doing this is, I mean, even if you pay $100 extra every month, you're gonna save thousands and thousands in interest payments. So that's a good thing. And then last little tip is have a decent amount to put down, or your upfront cost, or your upfront price you're gonna pay. Save up a decent amount so that you can have some power in negotiating with the bank. All right, and yeah, I guess that kind of sums up the mortgage financing. Thanks.